One of the greatest miscommunications between scientists and the general public surrounds the word theory. Though in day-to-day vernacular, a theory is nothing more than speculation, in scientific circles, a theory is a rigorous explanation of phenomena that makes predictions. Theories are put through wave after wave of testing based on those predictions. Bad ones are quickly identified if their predictions don't agree with experimental observations. These theories may then be modified to make more accurate predictions, or they may be replaced altogether until what remains agrees with any experiment that comes its way. Let's look at an example from one of the brightest men to ever walk this earth, Albert Einstein. Prior to Einstein, the predominant descriptions governing light and gravity were Maxwell's electromagnetic theory of light and Newton's law of universal gravitation. Both descriptions were of great practical use, but both had their issues. Maxwell's theory implied a luminiferous ether as the medium for light to travel through, much like the ocean for water waves, but no experiment was ever able to detect it. Einstein's new theory of special relativity eliminated any need for ether as the medium for light, thereby agreeing with experimental observations. Newton's universal gravitation did nothing to address why gravity occurs and incorrectly predicted the precession of Mercury's orbit and the deflection of light rays by gravity. With Einstein's new theory of general relativity, curved space-time was used to explain gravity, and it made precise predictions where Newton's law fell short. Einstein's work is a quintessential example of new theories supplanting old ones in the face of new experimental evidence. But his theories made even more predictions. They suggested that measurements as concrete as time and space could dilate and contract based on a person's speed and their proximity to a gravitationally strong object. And though these ideas seem far-fetched, they are in complete agreement with experimental observations. In fact, you put them to the test every day with a device sitting in your pocket. GPS relies on satellites high above the Earth traveling at great orbital speeds and the precise atomic clocks contained within them. To be positionally accurate, our phones have to be able to read those clocks to an accuracy of 20 to 30 nanoseconds. Due to their immense speed, special relativity predicts that we should see the clocks in the satellites slow down by 7 microseconds per day. Due to the farther distance from the center of the Earth, general relativity predicts that we should see the clocks in the satellites gain 45 microseconds per day, a net difference of 38 microseconds. When designing the GPS systems, engineers took these effects into account, and without them, the positions given by our phones would increasingly be off by about 10 kilometers per day. Despite this obvious evidence and a slew of cosmological experiments supporting general relativity, it isn't perfect. So far, it can't be reconciled with quantum theory, and it breaks down when trying to describe objects such as black holes, suggesting that better, more complete theories exist. General relativity isn't perfect, but it has held up against tremendous scrutiny and accurately makes predictions needed to live our modern lives. But keep in mind, it's just theory. Darwin's theory of evolution by natural selection centers on the idea that populations of organisms change over time to adapt to their surroundings. If a specific trait allows a certain member of a species to live longer in an environment and therefore have more offspring, over time this trait will become more prominent in its population. The classic example of evolution is given by the Galapagos finches. Different islands in the Galapagos had slightly different environments, each with different food sources. For the finches, different beak shapes are favorable for the different food sources. A big one to crush open seeds, a slender one to reach hiding insects, or one in the middle to deal with pesky cacti. The finches with the best beak shape for their respective food source would live longer and have more offspring, meaning that over time, their beak shape would predominate in their population. With enough changes over many generations, brand new species were formed. The evidence supporting evolution by natural selection is extensive. The fossil record shows transitional species which connect dinosaurs to birds, land mammals to sea mammals, non-seed plants to seed plants, and even mammalian quadrupeds to bipeds. Anatomical evidence also supports evolution, one example being the preserved bone structure in the arms, wings, and flippers of all vertebrates. Even man's best friend has an incredible amount of features in common with a wolf, suggesting that the two had a common ancestor. We almost take this one step further by using artificial selection to breed for the features that we most desire. And now, our incredible power to sequence genomes and analyze various proteins is leading to extensive chemical evidence to support evolution. Now, it is true that science does not prove absolute truths. It merely makes suggestions. But many scientific theories have been shown to be accurate time and time again in the face of extraordinary experimental evidence, meaning that they are the most vetted and accurate statements humans have ever come up with. Many of them are vital to the technology in our modern lives. To discredit evolution because it's just a theory is akin to discrediting the theory of general relativity on the same premise. Remember that the next time you use the GPS in your phone to drive home.